For ankle dorsiflexion, you will have your patient in a seated position, leg hanging off the table with the knee approximately 90 degrees. Owen, what I want you to do is dorsiflex your ankle as far as you can go, and now let it back down. Because he was able to do that, full range of motion, we know that that is at least a 3. If he was not able to do that, I would palpate for the anterior tibialis. As you can see, he just barely did that, and it's right here. Now, because he was able to do that, I would see if he is a 4 or a 5. So I would apply resistance on the foot and stabilize on the tibia. So go about halfway with that motion and now resist me. 3, 2, 1. Very good. For plantar flexion, you will have your patient in a standing position, standing on one leg. They can stabilize themselves if needed. You will have your patient plantar flex on their body weight at least 5 times. If they're able to do that 5 times, then that is a grade 5. If they do it 2 to 3 times, that is a grade 4. And if they do it only about once, that is a grade 3. If they're not able to do it once, you will have them in a prone position. Owen, if you could, plantar flex your foot for me, your right foot. Now, because he's able to do this in this while laying down, that is a grade 2. If he was not able to perform this, I would palpate the gastroc to check if it's firing. If I can feel it firing, that is a grade 1. And if I do not feel it firing, that is a grade 0.